Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Liqo and Zone. My name is Alex Palesandro, and I'm here with Alessandro Rivero. Hi, Alessandro.
Hi.
So today we will talk about multi-cloud, and we will use several managed clusters with Liqo in order to create a multi-cloud very, very quickly. So we have created four clusters on public clouds, A, B, C, and D, and we will create a supercluster topology. So we will have A cluster, which will act as front-end cluster, and we will have B, C, and D as secondary clusters. So let's have a look to our clusters. We have A here. A is a cluster on AKS. B is another cluster on AKS. So we have two clusters on AKS. C is a cluster or GKE on Google Cloud. And D is a cluster or EKS on AWS. And so let's try to install them and see how Liqo perform with them. So we have Liqo CTL install. We have to specify on AKS several parameters, the resource group, the resource name, the subscription ID, and also the version that we want to install. We are installing a version that will be released in next days. So we are using an alpha deployment, an alpha version, sorry. And we have also to specify the MTU because different cloud providers may have different values on the MTU. So we have to specify which is the maximum common MTU that we can use dealing with a multi-cluster. Okay, so we have done that for the first AKS. Okay, so let's do the same for the second cluster. No difference for now. If we go to the third cluster, so let's clean a bit our screen. We see that with Google, we have some differences. So for example, we have to specify the cluster ID. We have to specify the cluster zone, the project ID, and also a service account path. So the credentials that are required in order to be able to scrape information about the cluster, to detect which are the IP of the cluster, and so on, to let Liqo install it. So let's trigger the installation. It's okay. So we have the third cluster, which is on undergoing. And finally, for EKS, we have to specify the cluster region, we have to specify the cluster name, and the same parameters as the other cluster. So it's pretty simple. Okay, so now we have one cluster which has already completed, and we are waiting for B, C, and D. So cluster A is completed, cluster B is completed, cluster C is undergoing, cluster D is undergoing. So if you want to know on Liqo if your cluster is okay, we have a command in Liqo CTL called Liqo CTL status that tells you if the installation has gone fine and Liqo is operating well on your cluster. Perfect. So everything went fine also on D, and we are waiting for C to be ready. Okay, so the installation has finished. We have already checked cluster A, so let's check the other cluster using Liqo CTL status. So cluster C is okay, cluster B is okay, and cluster D is okay. So perfect. So now we can move to the peering. So as we mentioned before, we want to recreate a topology like the following. So A as a primary cluster, B, C, and D as a secondary cluster. We can use the generated command on the cluster. So first of all, I think, Alessandro, we can have a look to the nodes on the primary cluster. Uh-huh. What do you think?
Sure.
So we can see that there is no virtual nodes or Liqo stuff on this cluster. So it's completely clean. So let's use generated command, okay, on the cluster. So we have the command to trigger the peering from cluster A to the other clusters. So we have triggered the first one, the second one, and the third one. Okay, so and here we have. So let's go inside. We see that all of them are labeled with a specific label, which means that that cluster belongs to a specific provider. So those labels are attached during the installation by Liqo CTL, and you can use them to decide where applications should go. So now we have a simple cluster with three physical nodes, three virtual nodes, and we would like to use the virtual node resources to host some applications. So let's start with the first one. We start by looking at namespaces because the first application, which is the online boutique application, we just want to have them on AKS. So we create the namespace and we use Liqo CTL offload the namespace Liqo demo to create it.
Okay.
Okay, so as we mentioned before, we have the accepted cluster labels here, which specifies that all this namespace should be offloaded only on the AKS labeled cluster, so on B, and not on C or D. This is very important, and in fact, Liqo did not replicate it. This namespace on C and D. So this worked perfectly. Another thing that we told to Liqo at using offload command is that we want to use an offload strategy which is remote, which means that the basic idea is do not allow pods to be scheduled locally on available resources, but you should use the virtual nodes. Okay, so let's...
You can create the other namespace.
Yeah, exactly. So we create, for example, another namespace, and we want to have the application replicated on any cluster. So very simple, remote. We do not specify anything. And so this will create the namespace, replicate the namespace on every possible cluster. With the Liqo STL offload command, you can decide the perimeter of your application in your multi-cluster topology. So now we can, I think, deploy the application and see how it works. So we can do the apply on the Liqo demo. So the application should be only on the cluster B because it's the only AKS cluster that we have. And we specify that Liqo demo namespace should be only on cluster B, so only on AKS clusters and should not be local. We can see that all the replicas, all the pods are on the very same node. So it worked as expected. And we observe that here we have all the pods which are local and they are created inside the namespace Liqo demo something something, which means that it is the reflected namespace from the cluster A. So we just create a new application, not in a local cluster, but in a remote cluster. So the user has applied the application only on cluster A, the manifest only on cluster A. Now I think we can have a look to the application when the pods will be up and running. So the application has been created. So if we look to the application and to see the IP that we see before, everything is working fine. So we are accessing the application from cluster one. The application is on cluster two, but everything is working fine. We can access the application also directly from cluster 2 because we specified a load balancer service. But the basic idea is that from the point of view of a user that uses this supercluster, it accesses the cluster A, it offloaded everything on cluster B, but everything works. But we only triggered this deployment from cluster A. So now I think we can move to the second use case, which is more complex because we decided to put the application not only on one cluster, but all the clusters of our multi-cloud. So now we are applying the very same manifest. And let's have a look to where the pods have been deployed. So this is Liqo demo 1.
Sorry. So
the previous one. If we look to Liqo demo 2, we can see that we have different namespaces here, which means that the application have been scheduled on cluster C and D because cluster B was already full of workloads. So the scheduler of cluster A decided to put application in cluster C and D. And we can see that we have some of them in the GKE cluster and a lot more on the cluster EKS. So let's have a look to the application now. I don't know if everything is running. Yes. No. Okay, so now we'll check see if this website works or not. So let's copy the IP. Perfect. So the application has been deployed on two remote clusters, on GKE and on EKS. And we are attaching the application from the AKS endpoint, and everything works fine. So the basic idea here is that the developer can drop the application, DevOps can apply the manifest. The application will go on a cluster which has been allowed by a policy that we put in the namespace. And at the end of the day, the application will work as it is on the local cluster. So no difference from the user perspective. Okay, so thank you very much for your attention. And if you have questions, you can post them in the comments. you can subscribe the channel or give us a star on GitHub if you like the project. Thank you very much and have a nice